Hey, what's going on, guys? So this is actually my second time doing this video because I actually uploaded it and then realized that it somehow got messed up with the sound, so I have to redo this now. But for day three of this challenge, I wanted to analyze some cool harmony from the band Hiatus Kaiyote, and this is from the song The World It Softly Rolls, and this is the live version. If you just search that song on YouTube, I'll provide the link in the description, but it's one of the main versions that come up, and it's really cool, and they do some awesome stuff in it. And this is a little different, because I did want to maybe look at some chordal type stuff and try and pull some concept from it, but I'm also kind of just analyzing the basic harmony behind this song, but I think that there's some cool points that you can take from it when you look at it. So let's just start. So basically, I kind of see the main harmony, it's like a repeating like four chord or four harmony sequence, but there's more of like a functional version of it in the beginning that you can relate the second part to, but in the second part, the second half, they kind of retain the original harmony in a way, but the substitutions that they're using are kind of doing a different thing where they're using parallel harmony, but it kind of relates to the original harmony, so we'll take a look at it. So let me just play some parts of it. So the song opens up, so you want to get the bass line in your head. It's just four notes that is the bottom end of all the chords. It's basically D, G, C, B flat, D. It's a little loud. Okay, so that really grounds this in the whole song. And I'm playing it an octave higher because I don't have a low D on the guitar. So then, here's the actual chords that fill in the bass line. Okay, it's right here. One second. Okay, same notes are in the bass. Okay, so you hear the chords? Okay, so when I analyze it, this is what I get. First of all, we already know what the bass line is. And the melody on top, generally speaking, most of the time through is... Okay, so you know that that's going to be the top end of the chords. So when I analyze these and I fill in the chords, this is what I get. And if you're curious, I'll just tell you like the voicings I use if you want to know specifically how I play them. So the first chord I have is a D augmented chord. So I have the 5th fret of the A string, the 8th fret of the D string, and then 7th fret of the B string, D augmented. And then the second chord I have is like a G minor triad. So I'm basically just barring the 3rd fret. So I'm playing the low E string and then the G, B, and high E string, right? So far, okay? The next chord I have is like a C diminished 7th, which I'm playing like this, okay? It can also be thought of as an A diminished 7th, well, you know, diminished is symmetrical, but we'll talk about that when we're making sense of these chords in a second. The way I'm playing this, I have my 3rd fret of the A string, 4th fret of the D, 4th fret of the B string, and then 5th fret of the high E. Okay? Then I have a B flat major 7 chord with a B flat in both the bass and the melody. And so basically, I have like the low E string 6th fret, the D string 7th, the G string 7th, and then the high E string 6th. Pretty basic B flat major 7. And then the last chord I have is like basically like a inversion of like an E flat major 7 sharp 11 or like an E flat Lydian, but again, because the last note in the bass line is D, so it's like the major 7 is in the bass. So I'm playing it like this, basically the like it's almost like I barred the 10th fret, but I have the low E string 10th fret, the 13th fret of the D string, 12th of the G string, and then the 10th fret for the B and E string. Okay, so it's a really nice progression. Sorry. Right? So, if I have this incorrect, it'd be cool if the members of Hiatus Kaiyote want to correct me. But that's what I'm hearing. So to me, that's like the functional version of this harmony, and it makes sense. If you think of the general key center as either B flat major or G minor, which are relative major and minor keys, so the D flat augmented is kind of like the five, like almost like an altered dominant sound. It doesn't have a seven, but it's like an altered, because it's augmented, five chord moving to the minor tonic, the G minor. So it's the 5 to 1. And then, like I said, this diminished chord, which, because C isn't a bass, I'm thinking C diminished 7, but C diminished 7 is also the same thing as A diminished 7, and the chord coming after is B flat major, and it's a very smooth, typical passing diminished chord. Okay, if you have a chord that you're approaching, like a major chord in this case, you know that you can approach it with passing diminished chords either a half step below or a whole step above, which is the same thing. And it kind of relates to that dominant to tonic type of cadence, okay? So it makes sense approaching the B flat. And then from there, we're in the key of B flat major, we just go up to the fourth, to the sharp 11 order, okay? So when you analyze the chords like that, you can see that it actually is pretty functional. Nothing really non-functional, if you really think about it. So then, when we get to the second half of this song, so I'm just gonna let it play out here. Right now they're just kind of vamping on this E flat major 7 type sound. Rhythmic stuff. Okay, so first they're gonna go into these other chords that, to be honest, I have a really hard time hearing what they are because the tone of the keyboard is like this electric piano sound right here. They're really cool chords. These chords. But I have a really hard time hearing what they are. But if anyone wants to try and figure it out and tell me what they are, that'd be awesome. But the chords that are coming up next is what I'm going to be referring to. These chords. Okay? Okay? So basically, what I'm hearing is I'm hearing a series of parallel major 7 chords, and he's using different voicings. That give nice voice leading for each one, but the basic major 7 chords, just by definition that I'm hearing, are like a F major 7 to like a C major. I'm kind of playing just like a C major there, but F to C major 7 to B flat major 7 to A flat major 7 and then E flat major 7, and he does it with the Lydian. Okay, if I play it with it. So now they go back to this part, but he's gonna do it again in a second, and I'll play it so you can kind of hear it against what they're doing. This is what I'm trying to take from this, because again, I'm always trying to pull a concept out of this, even if this isn't necessarily like a lick that you can add to your lead vocabulary. But to me, even though it's a different chord progression, it kind of retains the sound of the original functional progression. And there's a couple reasons why I think that is. First of all, the bass player is playing the same bass line. And I think that that grounds it and really retains the sound. The bass motion is very important. Okay? But also, the fact that the last chord, the destination, is the same. I'm playing it differently. Before, I played it like this. I'm kind of using whatever voicings I want here. I'm not figuring out his voicings exactly, but in the second progression, I'm playing it like this. Which is a nice way to voice like a major 7 sharp 11 chord. Basically, you got the root, major 7, I'm sorry, root, sharp 11, major 3rd, and then major 7. Okay? But because the same chord, generally speaking, is the same, even if the chords like are different, they if they're cadencing in a smooth way, they kind of retain the original sound of the progression. And if I play them back to back, you can kind of hear it. So this is the original progression. Right? And then the new progression. Right? So hopefully you can kind of hear how they're similar. So what you can kind of pull from this, if you want to incorporate it into your own playing, is you got to look for examples or situations where you can use this, where you can kind of use parallel harmony as substitutions for maybe an original functional chord progression, where the final chord or the final destination is the same. And this is not my first time learning Hiatus Coyote music, and this is a commonality that I find. They like to use parallel major 7 chords in a lot of their music. And typically, if you look at the way that those major 7 chords are moving intervallically, what I find a lot is they're moving in a lot of fourths or fifths, which are inversions of each other, or whole steps. And if you look at these chords, they're doing just that, because F moving to C is of going down a fourth, and then C to B flat is down a whole step, B flat to A flat is down a whole step, and then A flat to E flat is going up a fifth. And if you look at those intervals, especially when it comes to parallel harmony, those are smooth motions that create a sound where the chords are cadencing in a way that sort of sounds logical. Okay, so I'm rambling around the point, kind of being really repetitive here, but that's what I would take from this, is that you can experiment with using harmonic substitutions with parallel harmony, and just always be aware of what your destination chord is. And as long as the destination is the same, you could kind of use whatever sort of chord motion you want. But again, also let me remind you that the bass line is the same in both versions, so I feel like that's also retaining the sound of the original progression. So hopefully you can pick up what I'm putting down here, and I hope that you enjoyed that, and I'll see you in the next video. Enjoy your day.